Hello, MS World. This is Jennifer coming at you from ECTRIMS 2017. I'm here at a very colorful display from Digesting Science. This is so interactive and so cool. So could you tell us your name and tell us a little bit about what Digesting Science is?
Yeah, sure. Hello, I'm Becky. Hi, everyone. And I work with Digesting Science. It's from the BartsMS team. We're based in London. But now we're here, obviously. And Digesting Science is a kit, and it's for children who have a parent with MS. And it's to teach them a little bit more about the condition and about the science behind the condition. We have also run this group at Great Ormond Street Hospital in London with children who have MS themselves. So it works that way as well.
So what's in the kit?
So basically, it comprises, if I just move over here and tell you, you can see that there are 5 boxes here, and there's also another box, which we call the toolkit, which has everything in it that you need to run the event. And so these 5 bits, these 5 boxes have different games and activities, one in each. So maybe if I just talk through what some of them are.
That would be fantastic. Let's start with the vitamin D, because that's always a big topic in MS.
It is, yeah. So if you can see just above the box, there's the burning question, how can we prevent MS? And so the team looked at recent data, which suggested that a deficiency of vitamin D could be possibly linked to contracting MS, and also that children who have a parent with MS are slightly more likely than the general population to develop MS themselves. And so this was part of where the project comes from. We were thinking of a way in which we can encourage the children of people with MS to think a bit more about their vitamin D intake. And so this is a game, and when you open it up, there are some lovely yellow tokens, like the yellow dots here. And you also have 2 towers, which are, when you play the game, they're not full of badges. And you pick up a card, and it will tell you something. So for example, you spent all day outside cycling, you can take a little scoop of vitamin D. So you would take a scoop of those little yellow tokens and put them in your tube. And then the next person would pick up a card and it would say, you took a vitamin D supplement, get a big scoop of vitamin D. Or you spent all afternoon in front of the computer, no vitamin D for you. Or you went on holiday to Scotland, no vitamin D for you. So then it's the first person to fill up their tube, basically, wins the game. So it's just a little games like that to kind of get kids thinking. And then they'll be wearing one of these lanyards on the table. And after the game, they can get a stamp when they have answered a question to show they've understood the main take-home message of each box.
Excellent. So let's move on to, how does MS affect your bladder? What is in that little box there?
Okay, so first of all, before I describe the game, we thought this is very important. The developers of the kit thought it was very important because this is quite difficult sometimes for people to talk about, and especially to your children. So we wanted to think of a fun way to explain this, but that also would kind of help perhaps that conversation, which can be a bit tricky. So there are actually 3 elements to this game. First of all, we set up some dominoes, and then you can knock down a row of dominoes. And there's another row of dominoes with some of them missing. And when you go to knock it down, not all of the dominoes fall down. And that's demonstrating that sometimes the signal does not travel all the way from the brain to the bladder where you want it to. And this is another game to explain that idea. There are 2 of these in the box, laid out along the ground. And these little yellow coverings, that's myelin. And so you have to walk all the way along the nerve cells, standing on every single one. And obviously, when there's myelin, you don't have so many to step on. So if there are 2 in a row, one of them is demyelinated, so you take off the yellow thing. And then obviously, if 2 kids walk along, the one who has the myelin will walk along quicker than the one who has to step on every single. So that's another demonstration that sometimes it takes longer for the signal to get down from the brain to the bladder. Oh, sorry. Finally, in this box, there's a bucket of water and a squeezy bottle. And if you open the cap and squeeze the bottle, then the water comes out. That just shows how a normal bladder functions. If you shut the cap and squeeze the bottle, that demonstrates when you need to go, but you can't. And if you leave the cap open and it drips, that shows you, that demonstrates incontinence, when you don't want to go, but you can't stop.
That is so awesome that it's so visual and demonstrative for kids. So how old would you recommend the children be to actually kind of participate in this game?
Yep, so in materials, we say that it's recommended for between the ages of 6 and 12. And this is because we developed this along with parents with MS and also teachers. And we thought about the ages at which they could grasp the concepts and the new words, things like myelin and things like that they would have to learn, but also the age beyond which they might find the activities a bit more tedious. We've had some great events where people have come along with younger siblings who've had a lovely time as well, and with older teenage siblings who've also gotten involved, but that's just generally a rough guide.
So for our MS parents out there, where can they find this game if they want to purchase it?
Okay, so at the moment, it actually is, it's a kit in the UK. We have 5 of them. And they are sent out to local MS groups or MS nurses, and MS organizations are also able to purchase the kit. So when they do so, obviously at no profit to us, we send out the kit and then they can put on an event. So it's an event not for one family, but for 5 really. And they sort of can come together for a morning or for an afternoon. And we find that the social element of that really helps with the understanding as well.
So as we are MS World, is this available internationally for patients or just in the UK right now?
So excitingly, we have a new ambassador program that we're wanting to launch at this conference. And so we're going to have some training available for people to come to London and have a couple of days training, really to get to grips with the kits and the science behind it, and then to return to their country with a kit. And so, if you're based in the US, then hopefully we'll have somebody who wants to purchase a kit to come over to do the training and then to return to the US with a kit. So, yeah. Keep your eyes open and look out for it. But we have a website, digestingscience.co.uk, and we're on Facebook as well and Twitter. So you can keep up with the latest news on the project there.
Can you talk to me a little bit about how MS affects your vision and how the game kind of helps to illustrate that?
Yep, sure. So this game demonstrates how the optic nerve works and how in MS you can sometimes develop temporary optic neuritis. So what you would do is you have the brain hat there, you make that yourself, and then you put the brain hat on, and then you put the goggles on, which have pipe cleaners. If I can just go over and show you. One side of the head has pipe cleaner with myelin on it. And then the other side, the pipe cleaner is demyelinated, so there's no longer any yellow bits on the pipe cleaner. So that shows then that the signal from the eye to the brain and back again can be disrupted. And then you would put Vaseline on the goggles, and it would show you that you have blurred vision, and that explains the idea of optic neuritis. And then we explain in the kit as well that optic neuritis is temporary. So when you get it, your vision then returns to normal afterwards.
That is a brilliant way to demonstrate that. I really, really like that. It's so visual. Helps me understand it too, honestly.
It's nice for the kids as well because they enjoy wearing the brain hats and the goggles, and they can do a brain hat selfie. So, yeah.
I would like to do a brain hat selfie. Is there anything else that we should look at?
Yeah, so down here we have the walking box. And this demonstrates with these shoes. You can put these shoes on, and it shows you that it's a bit tricky sometimes to walk when you have MS and the ground can feel a little bit uneven. And we also have some weights that go around your ankles. And once you've walked around a little bit in those, you can see that your legs start to feel tired. And it's... we've had some lovely feedback that children really start to understand, you know, why mum can't always take them to football or soccer and, you know, why they feel so tired sometimes. And it really brings out kind of the natural empathy of children, and they start to really understand, you know, where their parents are coming from.
I would think that this would actually be helpful to help other people, not just children, but maybe friends and family of MS patients, understand exactly what they're feeling and going through too. Have you found that at all, like friends and family kind of experimenting with this and helping to understand, gaining like a deeper understanding of what MS patients experience?
Yeah, absolutely. That's what's the lovely thing about these events, because they're locally put on. And then when people are invited, often the whole family comes along. Sometimes an auntie comes along to help as well, or a friend. And it's really nice because everybody gets involved and the activities really involve all of the family. And it's nice not only for the children to learn about the parents and for that conversation to go on, but parent to parent as well, to kind of deepen that understanding and sometimes reawaken the empathy that maybe day to day is kind of worn away a little bit. It's just really nice to have that space as well, because obviously life gets in the way. You're trying to get homework done, you're trying to get out the door for school and for work. It's not always possible to kind of have these conversations and really understand why dad feels the way he does. Or
and this is so important too, because I know that MS patients in our community are dying for people to understand exactly how they feel. So this is very demonstrative and elucidating for them, actually, just to have family and friends understand exactly what they're going through and why they can't do certain things. So this is wonderful that you've done this. Are there any other components to the game that you'd like to share with us?
Yep, so there's one more that's hanging up here. I should also say that there are a few little games that aren't kind of shown here. So for example, there's one called How Big Is Your Brain? And that's the idea that it would be great for children to learn some of the vocabulary that goes along with MS and with the science. So things like myelin, things like optic neuritis. It's good for them to learn new words. And so we've got some of these words on a wall. And when you understand the word, when you know what it means, you can write your name next to it. And depending on the time of day, you use a different color pen. So at the end of day, at the end of the day, they can really see what they've learned. And also from an evaluative point of view, we can really see how much the children have learned just by the kind of the new words they know. And another thing that everyone does is to draw a little self-portrait. And then the children in the room have to identify everyone. Are you a person with MS? Are you a relative? Are you a neurologist? Are you an MS nurse? And so everybody in the room gets to know each other and everyone's roles are well-defined. It's really nice.
That is really wonderful. That's fantastic. I hope that we get something like that in the United States as well. So this is wonderful. Is there anything else that you'd like to share about? Oh, how about how do we treat MS? Can you talk a little about that?
Yep, so this one is a real highlight with the kids. They love it. So this this fellow here, he sits on a table and he's not very well. So he has some infections in the body. You can see four of them, these discs. And what we have are these really cute little hex bugs that you switch on. They're battery powered and they're white blood cells. So you release them into the body and they go and help the poor fellow and make him feel a lot better by fighting the infections. And when a white blood cell falls into one of the discs, you then cover it over and you fought that infection. And then the game goes on to explain that in MS, some of the white blood cells turn nasty and they start attacking the body. And so there are these little white blood cells with nasty faces. And then when you switch those on, they're thinner. So they can get through the blood-brain barrier and they start to attack the central nervous system, and that's what happens in MS, as you well know. And so after that, the treatments, a lot of treatments for MS at the moment, they start to modify the white blood cells so that they no longer attack the central nervous system. So there are little caps that you can put on the hex bugs, and when you slot one in and then put it back into the body, it is too big to fit through. So it no longer can go in and attack the central nervous system. So that's really fun for the kids because they get to switch on the little hex bugs and watch them buzzing around and say, oh, mine was the one that got the infection. And then they watch them go into the central nervous system and then obviously slot the things on so they can't go and attack the brain and the spine anymore.
This is so wonderful. It's so brilliant. I'm almost wondering if this would be great for patients who are newly diagnosed with MS as well, to kind of understand exactly what's going on with them instead of being given a bunch of textbook kind of jargon that they're given from their neurologist. Like, this is really interesting. Anything else you'd like to add?
I think perhaps it would be good to talk about how it was developed. So it was developed by BartsMS, and they are a research and a clinical team based in London at Queen Mary University and in Whitechapel at the Blizzard Institute and the Royal London Hospital. And they worked together with designer Alison Thompson, who wanted to understand a little bit more about their work and got them initially to demonstrate their work in things like plasticine and then in food, hence the name Digesting Science. And then they started to develop these activities and decided that even though it was great fun, nobody wanted to kind of roll it out if they had to go to the supermarket and buy all the components in food to make it happen. And that's why then the actual kit was developed, because it could then more easily be sent across the country and it didn't need the scientists right there to explain because it's obviously so well demonstrated. But this was developed with scientists, with a designer, and also with teachers, with parents with MS, and we had lots of tester events with children as well. So it's really been a huge collaboration to bring it to life.
This has been wonderful. Thank you so much for sharing all of this with us. I mean, I really think this is fantastic, and people could learn a lot just from this, not only children, but MS patients as well. I learned things. Thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you. I really hope it gets to the US somehow, and that people can enjoy digesting science over there. Thank you for talking to me.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.